cut at all. Obsessed with that song. Why is he obsessed with it? It's the compulsive love affair. I'm gonna have to split this video and cut off that segment. Cut it right off. Too bad. They're in, you know, not thinking they're playing. about something serious. Yeah, something very serious going on. So I saw a few cop cars go by.
Pointed out, Adrian, he just said,
you want to kill all of them.
Even if I'm in trouble, I want to the female fan. We're wearing his jersey. And slapped him high fives when we realized we were going to suspend him 2 games and stuff. What were they thinking?
The fan, yeah, that's a really great point because, you know, it is clear from that kind of information that their allegiance to the team, their allegiance to the Baltimore Ravens, kind of outstrips their, you know, their sensibility about how they're going to react to this kind of abuse, to this kind of domestic violence. And you would think, as women especially, they would be that much more sensitive. Now, there is some evidence, there is some data more recently indicating that they say the research is showing that the percentage of women who now go through all of the NFL's games approaches something like 44%. So that's a very high figure. And I think on the other side of the scale of what you're pointing out is that incrementally, there are women who are getting turned off in sports, getting turned off in professional football sports because of what's been happening in the most recent episode scandal. And a very recent poll showed that since the Ray Rice episode, there's been a decline of 12% of the viewership of Monday Night Football. It's a rather interesting statistic. So it shows that at least in some quarters, there has been some impact of people being turned off or all of the domestic violence.
Take it in tomorrow morning.
So,
link or sell to. Now he's passing me on the right, illegal passing. I don't need my marker lights. Change his mind. Oh, they want to pass me.
Different locations, like when I went up to Boston, I had to go to Fenway and
Did you get to a point in the
For every bad individual, there's a good individual too that you could say, how can you not root for that guy?
Yeah, exactly.
I feel like that situation with the tight end, I don't really understand how you can blame the team. Sure, it's a messed up situation, but it doesn't change my perspective on my team and make me think any less of them. If anything, it makes me
think all of the
guys. I mean, yeah.
Maybe even more.
That's a heck of a party.
Another one again at the end of Peace Street for Liberty Street. We go towards home. Oh, and to go right home into my driveway. Weekend's really short. Shortest weekend. This is a call going out.
What's going on here?
Well, first of all, I wanted to put something in on that.
I said the Red Sox would win 69 games.
They won 71.
and it's good to baseball because from everything I know, and I think you know, Bill, he played the game right.
Well, yeah. Give me your starting line for next year's Red Sox.
I'm reading a book about the ABA, the American Basketball Association.
That was an experience.
That was hysterical. You know, at one point, for two games, the Atlanta Hawks could have fielded Pete Maravich, Julius Erving, and New Hudson all on the same team.
That's insane.
But then the courts intervened, and they ruled that Julius had to play in New York.
Oh, yeah. Well, they kind of make the rules.
Brisker, John Brisker, and another kid named Jamal, who was actually
Fighting guys and stuff. People were afraid to jump up and get rebounded. They used to punch you in the stomach. All of them felt.
Oh, yeah. It was an experience, to say the least.
John, you got some predictions for us this week?
I have a prediction.
Okay.
No, they're going this way.
Well, despite it, I believe that Rondo will be traded and traded probably by February because I think he's going to miss a lot of time and some team is going to feel that he can help them, you know, go for the gold, because last year the Celtics had a better record when Rondo was hurt than when he played.
Yeah. And, Rondo,
and I think by 2 months, he's going to be out 2 months,
yeah,
at least. He'll be out 2 months, and in my opinion, the team will be in a groove where they can't reset the game just for Rondo.
I'm getting tired of that. What did he do this time? Slipped his hand off, right?
He slipped in the shower.
That should be reversed.
Even though he was...
And the Celtics quote was, they had no reason, I believe something they said, they had no reason not to believe that.
Well, there's a picture of him that looks like at a trampoline park. And then,
well, can I tell you, you got time for a quick Celtics story?
Sure.
Well, everybody remembers that Larry Bird was and people said it was in a fight. Well, the PI guy, along with Jeff Twist, assigned a hearing this. So the question was Larry Bird in a bar having a fight? And my answer was yes. And is it true that Larry Bird threw a punch and hit?
Oh, they did it today. No, they didn't.
And I said,
tomorrow they should.
Now, the true story was that discussion, let's say, took place in a bar, but no fights were shown, just...